What is going on? Welcome back to the Rare Element Sports Card Podcast, brought to you by the Denver Card Shows and also brought to you by Pikes Peak Card Show. My name is Aaron. I'm here with my boy Jeremy. What's up, my brother? What is good?
Kicking and chilling. Kicking and chilling.
Kicking and chilling. Mm-hmm. Per the huge.
I'm surprised they haven't brought back the WhatsApp commercials yet, bro. Recycle everything.
Those were fucking good commercials. Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, I like those, and then the Budweiser frogs.
Budweiser has some good shit.
They used to. Yeah. They used to. They were like the ones for the Super Bowl that you were waiting for, bro.
Yeah, fucking A.
They were the ones, no doubt.
Yeah. No, but there's not even a Super Bowl commercial that you're ever like.
I know. That really matters. They're not even memorable. Yeah. 100%. But I don't know, man. Got some bad news. We got some bad news. This is gonna be our last pod. Some circumstances came up, and we're gonna have to wrap it up, I guess.
Yeah, we all gotta grow up sometime.
We gotta grow up sometimes. We can't just drink beer and whiskey and smoke weed and say shit and fuck all the time.
Yeah, yeah. Some extenuating circumstances.
But I mean, we don't have an agenda for tonight's show. We don't have our normal elements. We're just gonna shoot the shit and reminisce a little bit and say farewell.
Sip some whiskey
and just blowing kisses going off into the sunset.
yeah, you know, who knows, man, fucking what the future will hold, but for now, we're just going to have to chill.
Yeah, we're going to chill.
Time to chill. But it ain't like we got ran off by fucking anybody else in the hobby or like we fucking punking out because we feel like we didn't make it or anything.
No.
It was just like some shit fucking, you know, got to fucking switch shit up for a while.
Yeah, not at all. It was nothing negative, nothing bad. If anything, it's a good thing, to be honest. Yeah, you know, it's a good thing. So we're going to do our last pod tonight. Talk some shit and see where it goes. We have no agenda. This could be 20 minutes. This could be 3 hours. I don't know.
Word.
I don't know. We'll see where it ends up going.
How much beer we have.
I know, right? We got plenty of whiskey. Yeah. I mean, shit. Yeah. Might call off of work tomorrow and shit.
Whiskey and water.
Might pass out.
There's still some in that Buchanan's, too.
There is, yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, there is.
We got some stock for a trade night.
We got some. Yeah, we got some whiskey.
Yeah.
Shout out to Tony and this one. You got the Dwarves, right?
That was.
Yeah. And we got the proper 12
and the Buchanan.
And the Buchanan's.
Just random pickups.
A whole bunch of random pickups.
Trying to sample different shit. Random pickups, just like a card show.
Yep. We treat our whiskey like we treat our sports cards. Just a little random.
Yeah, I mean, I heard that fucking Denver show was a banger, though.
It was, dude. It was popping. It was a new venue. It was at the Delta Hotel up in, it's a Marriott, I believe, up in North Glen and almost Kansas, or almost Wyoming. It wasn't that far. It's about the same distance from to where the Crown Plaza was.
Oh, like, really? From here, anyway?
Time-wise. Yeah. I mean, almost to the minute.
Really?
So I was expecting it to be a little bit further, but it's not bad.
Not too bad.
Yeah, it's not too bad. The venue was nice. Brand new hotel.
Yeah, I saw some pictures. It looked pretty cherry in there.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. And the ballroom, like the big ballroom, was beautiful. It was well lit. Where we were, it was kind of out in the almost like the foyer type of place.
Yeah, so it was almost kind of two rooms.
Uh huh. Like two rooms, kind of adjacent.
Yeah.
Is that the word?
I guess
perpendicular, like they're like this.
They were connected.
They were touching, and it was good. It was good. The crowd was there. There's definitely a lot of people on quite a few tables, dude.
Yeah, awesome.
Sold a lot of stuff. Sold a bunch of Zion cases. It was a good Zion case show.
That's good.
And they had the trade night right in the same lobby as where the show was, and the trade night fizzled a little bit.
Did it?
It was. Okay.
Because people weren't staying the night.
That was part of it, I think. And also, I think that nobody knew where it was going to be. Throughout the whole show, everyone was like, where's the trade night going to be? Where's the trade night going to be? Yeah, I was like, I'm not sure. And it kind of popped off right there. And which was cool because, like, there was a Tony Roma's, like, connected to the hotel there. And where the bar is, like, a circular bar. And where we were sitting, you could see right into the venue. And you could see the trade night going on as we were having some dinner, and it was cool. It was a lot of fun.
yeah, I would have liked to have gone up for trade up. Then I would have had to get a room and just camp. That wasn't in the budget.
It wasn't in the cards.
Can't really fucking get a room if you're not fucking slanging too many cards.
That's true.
I mean, can, but I mean, you know.
It cuts deep.
Yeah.
But no, it was great. It was a great show.
Yeah.
Mr. Scanlon was taking submissions for SGC, and he took a ton, dude.
Oh, really?
He said he took almost double what he did at the last show. Wow. So
okay.
He was busy. He's a busy man. But yeah, all the mainstays, all the main guys here in the Colorado hobby that were vendors were there. Except Jeremy. But
stupid fucking open house to do, bro. Actually, the homie Scott came though. That was cool.
Oh, did he? Nice. Hell yeah. Did you have like food or anything at the open house?
Some fucking Little Debbie's.
Hell yeah. That's enough.
Little Debbie's and water. Yeah. Oh, Scott showed up and chilled for a minute, but yeah. Yep.
That's cool.
The show, but the plan was to go up there, but at last minute some shit to do, so.
Yeah.
Oh well.
Yeah. And everyone was like holding me accountable. They're like, where's Jeremy? I was like, oh, he's probably going to be up here a little bit later. He was planning on coming up after a little while. And they're like, oh, cool, right on. Where's Jeremy? I was telling people all day long. And then fucking, you didn't come. And they're like, dude, I thought you said he was fucking coming. I was like, yes, we said, bro.
I did say that.
I was like, I'm just repeating. Fucking chill out, man.
I did say that. I didn't know until like fucking Thursday I wasn't going to be able to go.
But you're always like when you're not there, dude, you're always missed. Everybody loves you, man.
I definitely miss not being there and setting up and shit, dude, and people coming up to the table and all that. That's fucking
yeah. Seth came by and got to talk with him a little bit. That was pretty cool, dude. Love chit chatting with him. He's a fucking cool dude.
Yeah I need to hit him up.
I felt bad because it was busy.
Yeah.
And people were coming up, and I was like trying to talk with them and trying to make deals at the same time. And I was like, I felt
it's
bad.
It's hard because, yeah, I mean, you're there to sell, you know. But man, the venue looked nice, and that's cool that there's like restaurants and shit. And like,
yeah, there's a Starbucks upstairs. Stuff to do. Oh, the Starbucks, dude. There was some honeys working at the really? Starbucks, like good ones, like good ones, dude. Like fucking.
But how are their wings, bro?
Like they were really like.
Mexican America. Oh yeah.
Nice. Smoke shows. The first one, I'm talking with her and getting my coffee, and she spoke English, but like it was broken, hot. And then the other girl that was working there came around the corner, and she was hotter and spoke less English. And I was like, oh my god, it just got better.
Selma.
It was pretty dope.
Yeah, that's cool.
It was pretty dope. And they had breakfast burritos. And so I was like, I saw this little sign said breakfast burritos. I was like, I'll grab white chocolate mocha, and I'll take one of those breakfast burritos. And I looked at the sign, and I saw it was $12.
Jesus.
And I was like, oh, my God. And I kind of could see them.
Yeah.
They were like that, dude.
They weren't from Starbucks?
They were from somewhere else.
Okay.
And they were hog legs.
Yeah.
They were big, dude.
Yeah.
They were big. I was like, all right, I'll pay $12 for that burrito. That's a meal.
Yeah.
You know, and it was fire.
Yeah.
It was good.
Nice.
But the Starbucks experience.
Did it have chili and shit in it?
Like, uh-huh. Yeah. Chili, bacon, okay. Eggs, cheese. It was good.
I don't know about where $12.
Well, I mean, I didn't want to look cheap in front of those girls.
Dude, anything from Starbucks less than fucking, yeah.
Yeah. I didn't want a bitch. Cause
I mean, yeah, at that point, yeah, it's already too late.
Oh, $12, that's it?
Yeah.
Oh, I got that.
Take them all.
I just sold a $20 card.
And a tip. Two tips.
But no, it was fun, dude. It was a good show. I hope if he ends up securing that venue, it'll be cool. It'll be a cool place. I don't know how well he'll be able to do the big show there. I don't know how much more space how many more tables he could push into there, because it was quite a few tables. Already. It was spacious, though.
Yeah.
It wasn't. They weren't real packed in, so maybe he could squeeze in some more. But it was a nice show.
Cue,
definitely cue. yeah, I stayed the night and I took care of the whiskey. I only had two or three. I didn't get carried away. Right. I didn't have to get carried out. Bless you.
Thank you. Lies.
Did not have to get carried out this
time. Just because I wasn't there.
That's probably true.
To be a bad influence. No, I'm just kidding.
Jeremy's like, dude, you could drink some more.
No, I sneak off and fucking smoke weed. And I drink a couple beers in between. I let you guys hit the fucking whiskey for everyone. I try to sneak in a beer or two and a water or two to fucking at least not fucking get blood alcohol poisoning.
Yeah. I try my hardest. I try my hardest to get blood alcohol poisoning.
Oh, man. That fucking last drink I was...
Got a little drunk.
I was fucking...
It's fun, though.
Had a little blood in my whiskey. Oh, it was so fun. It was so fun.
It was a great time. That was the last night with No Coast Labs, too.
Yeah.
He just was set up at a North Carolina show, and he was posting on the socials. It looked pretty cool.
Yeah.
But shout out to No Coast Labs.
Back in his home freaking area.
He's back down south.
Yeehaw.
Yeah, dude, fucking. So, Denver was going to be, Denver was dope. This next coming weekend is Pikes Peak. Pikes Peak's going to be. Pikes
Peak already this weekend?
Oh, wait, my bad. Two weekends.
Yeah.
Two weekends.
See, I thought All Seas was this weekend.
Yeah, All Seas is going to be this weekend. It's a 3-day show, too, so it's going to be at the Arapahoe County Fairgrounds. So, if anybody's in the Denver area, definitely go check it.
You guys going there?
No. 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 I have a bunch of stuff going on. But they have a pretty good mix of TCG and comic books and toys, and it's a pretty big all around collectibles type of show.
Yeah,
there's definitely sports card vendors there as well. So
yeah, it's more like a collect-a-con kind of thing.
Yeah, yeah. Almost. And they're fucking awesome people. We're set up across the across the hall from them at the Denver show, and it was cool. I love talking with James and Kenny. They're good guys.
Yeah.
So definitely go check that show out. Like I say, it's a 3-day show, and it's gonna be awesome. They usually have a ton of autograph guests, a lot of comic book illustrators, and a lot of people that do a lot of that sort of stuff there that sign. And I believe they're having a couple of sports people too. I want to say they're gonna have Carl Mecklenburger.
Oh, I think that's right. Every once in a while, they sneak a few Broncos in.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's right. I think they do have Mecklenburg and maybe another.
I think another Bronco or former Bronco.
Orange Crush era Bronco, feel like.
That sounds right.
Yeah.
Yeah. But check it out. Definitely a good time. Good people. And they have food, and they have a whole nine yards, so.
Yeah, they have some nice food trucks and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then Pikes Peak a week after that, huh?
Yep.
Is the big show for September confirmed? Does he have dates and stuff for that yet? I know he's been saying that for sure he's going to do one, but.
Yeah. I don't think they're confirmed.
No.
Not yet.
Word. Word, but there will be potentially a big show in Springs coming up in September. So.
Yep. It'll be at the Norris Penrose Event Center as well, but it's going to be in the Outdoor Event Center, which is much, much bigger, and we're going to see what we can do with that and pack it with as many people as we can.
It's not outdoors. It's just... The other
no, it's not. It's out in the parking lot, setting up some tents. No, it's a big arena area. It's a big event center, indoor event center, and they host a lot of big shows and different types of conventions in there as well. So, it should be cool. So, I want to get more. No, I'm not.
Sorry about that.
But no, definitely. Keep in contact with the socials. We're going to have those up for a while, I believe. And, you know, we'll run those for a while, see where it goes. And
yeah, and you can always fucking hit up at the shows and shit.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely.
I won't be able to set up as much as I used to, but I will as often as I can. And still at least try and go, you know?
Yeah.
Fuck pussy. Yeah, I definitely should have fucking went to that last Denver show. Needed to fucking thin out some inventory.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it would have been fun. I had planned on it the whole fucking time, but I wanted to see the new venue and I wanted to eat at that restaurant.
Yeah, Tony Roma's, it was good. I got a fucking
go grub there.
Yeah. I got a gigantic hamburger. It had pulled pork on it. It was fucking fire. It was good. And we got to sit down with Tim, have a couple of drinks with Tim. You know, the guy who sets up and has all the vintage cards.
Oh,
Tim Oliver.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Cool.
He sat down with us, and Irvin, good old Irv, sat down with us as well. So it was a nice dinner.
That's cool.
Yeah, it was cool.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Sat there, and we were watching some baseball. There was some good baseball on, and there was some, there was some NCAA basketball playing too. So there was a lot of sports, and it was a good time, dude. Excuse me. It's not bad manners. It's just good beer.
Word. Let it out, man. Let it out, Homer.
Get your tongue out.
His tongue, like, flails. Yeah. Man, I haven't watched The Simpsons in a while.
No, me neither, bro. I used to love that shit.
I used to not miss it.
They still make new episodes, right?
Yeah.
I think they do.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And that show's been running forever, dude. Since I was a little kid.
I was in early middle school, for sure. I want to say sixth grade, maybe.
I want to say third or fourth grade.
Maybe younger, but yeah.
Yeah. I got sent home for wearing a Bart Simpson shirt that said hell.
Yeah, they would send kids home for wearing Bart Simpson shirts.
They would sometimes let you tape over it and you could stay, but they made me go home, dude. I was like, fuck.
So, well, yeah, once kids found that out, they would fucking intentionally wear their fucking Bart Simpson shirt.
Oh, yeah.
Shit, I get to go home?
Absolutely. It's time to go. I'm going to wear this every day.
Yeah, my dad was a hater, though. He wouldn't buy me a Bart shirt.
No.
He's a hater.
Oh, my dad wouldn't buy it for me either. I bought it with my football card money when I would sell at the flea market.
He wouldn't let me wear a Bart shirt, I should say.
Oh, no?
They were kind of like, yeah, prude when I was young. Yeah. Then once they figured out they didn't work, they let my brother and sister do whatever the fuck they wanted.
That sucks.
Kind of.
That sucks.
Kind of sucks being the guinea pig, bro.
Right? Fuck yeah. That made me feel bad for my brother now.
By the time it got down to my brother, they were like,
whatever, bro.
Go ahead.
You want to shave your head? Yeah, fuck it.
Do whatever you want. Oh, yeah. I came home with my ear pierced. Oh, that my parents were pissed.
Really?
Oh, yeah. They were not happy. And then I came home with the pierced again, and they were not happy. And then I came home with my eyebrow pierced, and my mom was fucking, she almost slapped the shit out of me. She didn't. Because my fucking eyebrow was pierced with a stupid-ass fucking safety pin, bro, and it was like fucking through about an inch of fucking skin.
Oh.
It wasn't like, a piercing's just kind of supposed to go through the tip of your skin. Just
yeah.
Like, and then fucking I had Phil do it, bro, and the fucking,
oh, fuck.
He just fucking grabbed his hand. He's like, all right. And I was like, yeah, my whole eyebrow, bro, was like all the way around my eyebrow, like if my eyebrow was a fucking finger, dude. It was so swollen and shit, dude. Oh man, I took it out right away just because it hurt like a motherfucker and it looked stupid as fuck. What an idiot. Probably did it to impress some chicks or something.
I'll do it. I'll fucking do it right now, bro. That's hilarious.
Yeah, pretty lame.
Shit. I saw somebody pushed an earring through his ear to pierce it.
Their own ear?
Their own ear. Just like, yeah. Pushed it as hard as he could and fucking, you just heard it snap.
Yeah. Like, so I had my friends do mine, but I never didn't do my own, but yeah.
Yeah.
Just shoved the fucking earring through, bro. And it wasn't like the fucking.
No, it was dull.
Pokey one. Yeah. You know, like that's made for that shit.
Right. It was dull. It was not made for that shit.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty dumb.
Yeah, it happens. It happens, bro. We used to like try to give each other and ourselves like fucking shitty makeshift tattoos.
Yeah.
You're like scratch the skin and fucking put ink in there and like fucking scratch it in and like try to like rub it in till it was a fucking tattoo.
Yeah. Fucking stupid. Fucking dumb.
Dumb motherfuckers. But nah, you're young. You don't know. What the fuck do you know?
No, how much?
But yeah, dude, I remember that buying that Bart Simpson shirt with my sports card money.
Yeah.
My grandpa used to let me, he used to set up and he used to let me fucking set that little table and that's put out some cards and sell dollar card, $5 cards. And back then to me, that was a lot of money. I was like, yeah.
Yeah. And then you probably get like a few adults be like, Just buy some shit off of you to fucking.
Just to be, oh, look at this kid. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's like somebody buying a lemonade from a lemonade stand.
I'll give you a dollar for that, buddy.
Right.
But, I mean, obviously, you probably had some good stuff, too, or whatever. But
decent, you know, yeah. Just
yeah. Maybe not good. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Pro set yeah. and tops and, something like, some of those 80 or late 80s.
Wanted, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But they would sell, dude. Yeah. They would sell, and I'd go buy more, and I'd have packs, and I'd fucking crack in packs, and, oh, that's a decent card. I'll put that one out. And, like, I mean, they were just out. I didn't even have them in sleeves. They were just
sitting there.
Sitting on the goddamn table. Getting warped and sun-baked.
Yeah. That's funny. Hey, you got a Bart Simpson shirt out of it.
Fuck yeah. And I would get bags of lime salt. I remember lime salt was like currency when mm-hmm. I was in middle school. And like fucking have bags of lime salt and trading. I'll trade you 3 or 4 of these for fucking some blow pops. And then it turned into like trading lime salt for a joint. It was like so a couple of the homies that were into some shit, they would fucking
lime salt for joint.
Trade you. It's like, I'll trade you these for that joint. Like, nah, bro, you need to that 10 more at least. Fuck, that's a lot of lime salts. It is a joint though. I've never never smoked weed before. All right, let's do it.
Let's see, that's worth $2. Lime salts are 10 cents a piece. So technically, if I give them 20 lime salts,
that's probably fair. We'd make cinnamon powder, cinnamon powder, slanging little bags of fucking powdered sugar with cinnamon oil in it, and mm-hmm. look like we're slanging yayo.
Yep. At that fucking Lake Farm, was it Lake Pharmacy?
Lake Pharmacy.
Is that what it was called?
Absolutely.
Yeah. On Lake and Jones or whatever.
Uh-huh. Right there. Yeah. Yep.
And they would sell the different flavored oils and things in there. And yeah, you can just go in there and buy a bag of, a bottle of cinnamon oil and bag of powdered sugar. Mix that shit up.
Fuck yeah.
Little fucking sandwich baggies.
Oh yeah.
Bam.
We used to make the cinnamon powder and we'd make cinnamon toothpicks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so just stick them in the bottle
uh-huh.
for a little while.
Let's have these little plastic bags with like 10 of them in there and have it wrapped up and sell them for like $1 a piece. Boom, 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 boom. That's how I got my first starter jacket was fucking doing that.
People fucking spending their lunch money on it.
Oh yeah. Fuck yeah, dude. It was, my locker was popular.
I never got none because I got free lunch. So I never fucking was able to buy any fucking lime salts or
yeah. Anything. Oh yeah, I would save up my card money and my lunch money. Before I knew it, I had a little wad,
yeah,
a little decent amount of cash, and go to the cafeteria and take one of those Fruitopias.
Bam,
living large, son, living large.
Fruitopia. The fuck was Fruitopia? Was it something? What was like special about it? I don't remember. I remember the brand, but like
nothing really. It was just super sugar.
What were they like?
They're like fruit drinks.
Was it? Did it have juice in it?
Yeah.
The fuck is juice? I remember the name, but I don't really remember.
Purple drink.
Drinking them or like.
Yeah, remember. Yeah, they were like they were juice. They were juice, but they were good. Yeah. They were fire.
Yeah.
They had that kiwi strawberry passion. That shit was good.
Yeah,
I used to imbibe with Fruitopia a lot.
Yeah.
And I did too,
but I can't picture them.
When I was in high school, up on the fifth floor, right by all the science classes, they had a Fruitopia machine.
A machine. Oh damn!
And fucking, I was leaving my science class and I was walking by and I kind of like. Looked over at it and I saw something that didn't look right, dude. And I was like, because they were 50 cents. You buy them for 50 cents.
Mm.
And it looked like it said a dollar. And I was like, that's not right. And I went back and it said a dime.
Oh, shit, son.
So whoever set that machine up programmed it wrong. So we were like, oh, word. And we went fucking sticking dollars in there, just boom, 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 just fucking filled our backpack with Fruitopias for like 10 bucks. We had so many of them.
Yeah.
I was like, fuck yeah. We emptied that machine. So we got all those, shoved them in my backpack, went to my locker, fucking started putting them away, went back upstairs to go get more, and they were gone.
Mm.
Somebody, they already hit
them all out.
Yeah. Somebody fucking already cleaned it out. We're like, fuck. It's like, I knew we should have said, had somebody stay here.
Probably one of the teachers.
Probably. Mr. Benedetto was like, oh shit, 10 cents?
I got a $10 bill right here. I'm cleaning this whole machine out.
Yeah, it was. That was out of cards when I was in high school. I didn't fuck with cards at all.
I think I did a little bit as a I mean, I did here and there, like, not consistently at all.
Yeah.
I pretty much stopped collecting when I was a freshman, and I would, like, maybe buy a box or two a year here or there, but it wasn't, like, consistent all the way through for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't start buying cards again. And
that's when everything was getting out of whack anyway.
It was pretty like, bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. I wish I would have, though, because I was, like, 90. I graduated 97. So, like, 96, 97 would have been prime time to be buying cards, Kobe's and Iverson rookies and that's shit.
Went right when I was just out of high school. So, for sure, fucking between, like, 95 and 98, fuck no, dude.
Yeah.
I fuck about cards.
Yeah, I didn't care.
About maybe, not even, honestly, till about 2000, and I bought a few. That's how I ended up with that Brady rookie and shit.
Yeah.
I mean, I bought a little bit here or there, maybe, as an impulse buy or something.
Yeah. But yeah.
Never went out of my way to go buy cards from... probably 93 to 99, 98, 99.
That sounds about...
Yeah.
Maybe
once or twice I might have went to the card shop in that time.
Maybe. Yeah.
But
yeah, yeah. I was about the same, I'd say. I stopped really buying cards when I was in, like, 7th grade, 8th grade. And then I started partying and chasing girls and stuff, and... I didn't buy any cards until about 2005.
Yeah.
And then I started buying a bunch. I started going to Paul's, Rocky Mountain Sports Collectibles here in town, and I was going over there. And all the other shops had closed down at that point.
Yeah, yeah. There was nowhere else.
That was the only spot in town, and I was...
little tiny, somebody would have start selling some at another little store here or there.
Yeah.
Nothing.
But no major, yeah. Card
shop. Yeah.
But Paul's was a full-blown... shop. He had mm-hmm. he had hobby boxes, and he had, you know, decent cards in there.
Mm-hmm.
And it was cool that he showed up at our show, that past show that we had.
Yeah.
He was like, so many people here in town, like, he was their connection to cards.
Yeah.
He was walking through the show like a fucking celebrity.
Right.
Waving like the queen. Yeah. Waving. But it was cool to see him. Yeah,
he was the last one standing for a long time.
Yeah. Yep. And he taught me a lot about more of the modern stuff. And
even that shop that he took over was a shop before he took it over.
Was it really?
Yeah, that was the other guy, John, that had came and set up. John Hernandez.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't know that.
He was there, and then he moved to, he had a couple different spots, but yeah.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if he sold it to Paul, and maybe Paul bought some of his stuff.
Maybe. I don't remember. Yeah. But
yeah. I know when he took, because he had that big Raiders mural on the wall. Fucking jerk.
Boo. Boo. Yeah, dude, it was cool, though, because, like, that was right around, like, Adrian Peterson's rookie year, and Aaron Rodgers, and Marshawn Lynch, a lot of the guys that kind of developed into big stars as I was becoming an adult, you know. And I had a ton of all that shit, dude. I had tons of those rookies. I had so many good rookies that I fucking sold off over the years, you know. Tons of nice turkey red Brett Favre rookies, and I had some decent autos. I had some DeMarcus Ware autos, and like some pretty good ones, dude. And fuck, Adrian Peterson rookie auto, and I would get into it and have them for a while, and then I'd be like, what am I going to do with all these?
Yeah.
And I'd fucking
go. Like, that was kind
of
dumb.
That was stupid. That was a waste of $300. And I would sell them on eBay, and then I would end up going back and buying a couple more boxes. And then I started working at Little Caesars when I was in college, and my buddy Nick, he was my manager, and he's like, bro. And he was like kind of afraid to tell me. He's like, we got in his truck, and we were going, I can't remember what we were doing. We were going to the liquor store. Oh, I know. I went to his house for a De La Hoya fight, and we're going to the liquor store to pick up some beers and stuff. And he had a box of Top Strata that he had bought from Paul, and had it. It was like half ripped and like half unripped. There's still unopened packs in there. And I was like, dude, you fuck with cards? And he's like, yeah. And he was like, kind of like, didn't want to say, like,
he was like embarrassed.
Yeah, almost. Kind of. I was like, dude, I fuck with cards too. And he's like, do you really? And he's like, what do you have? And I was like, a little bit, you know, not a lot.
Yeah.
And I always had my childhood shit. And the next day at work, he's like, "We're going to go to lunch, bro." I was like, "All right, let's go." And fucking he took me over to the card shop.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. He's like, "Have you ever been in here?" And I was like, "No." Oh, no. I had been in Paul's. I was like, "Yeah, but no, it's been a while." And he's like, "Yeah." He's like, "This guy's cool as fuck." And we would go in there and fucking buy shit. And he wanted some. He's like, "I want to get a Peyton Manning rookie, bro." And he'd go in there and ask Paul. I was like, "Do you have any Peyton Manning rookies?" And he'd pull out a whole box, dude. 3-row box of just Manning rookies. He's like, "Whichever one you like the best." And fucking Nick picked out a numbered one. It was sick. And I didn't even know what numbered cards were at that point, really. And Paul would explain it to us, and he'd break it down. And he's like, "Yeah, there's autographs and stuff." I'm like, "What?" It's like, "Yeah, they'll sign, and they'll put them in the packs." And that was the most amazing thing in the world to me. When I found out that they were fucking signing autographs in there, I was like, "That's the shit."
Game used jersey cards and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I would go back and buy more cards and buy more cards. Before I know it, I had a lot of them. Then I would sell them.
Yeah, dude, when they first started putting game jersey cards and shit, even fucking commonest player was $20.
Mm-hmm. Nah, but it was fun. It was fun learning, kind of learning cards over again. And then now, this last time when I got back in, I kind of had to learn all over again, once again, you know, with all the parallels and case hits and all the different shit that was going on.
Yeah, because it used to be they were just number one thing. And that's where the one of 500 and whatever mattered.
Right. You
know, the eBay one of one.
Right. Call it now. Right.
And even on a huge numbered parallel, like out of 700 and something, if it's number one out of it or 799 out of it, that's cool-ish.
Yeah.
But if it's numbered out of 25, it's 25 out of 25, nobody really cares.
Right.
There's a few people that collect that shit, and you might get a slightest little fucking bump out of it to the right guy, but
yeah.
Generally, I don't even advertise it that way. Like,
even I wouldn't selling either,
it on eBay or anything.
Mm-mm.
I might put it in the listing 25/25 or... You know,
what number it is, yeah.
I'll do that a lot of times anyway.
Yeah.
Sometimes people collect a certain number just because it's their birth year, 77 out of
100
or some shit. Or
yeah.
You know.
It's true.
Any random reason just to collect because it's a little different. It's for their special PCE.
Right. You know? These are all my 10 cards.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah, the fucking hobby's come a long way, bro. It's come a long way since back in those days. Remember buying those 87 Topps baseball packs when there was no parallels or no nothing.
Packs of like 1990 cards where you don't even realize that, yeah, there's no way that this can be worth anything.
Right.
Just because it's a rookie card, I mean, there's millions, dude.
So many.
Mm.
So many. It drives me crazy when I hear people say, "Oh, it's a new junk wax era. It's a new junk wax era." It's like, you don't understand.
Yeah.
It's not even close to that.
Yeah. I mean, it's a little flooded, but it's not that.
It's not that. And there's rarity built in with the serial numbering and grading and stuff. So there's rarity to be put in there.
Yeah. I mean, and there's plenty of cards from the junk wax era that are worth a lot of money as a 10.
Yeah. Yeah, Elway rookies.
Not a ton, but there's
some shit.
Quite a few.
There's some shit. Absolutely.
So, yeah, especially like baseball. Tony Gwynn's and things, guys like that, and Anderson and
mm-hmm.
those guys. Those cards are impossible tens.
Right.
The only tens that ever show up now, I was kind of thinking about that the other day, is like anything high grade out of any of that older shit is actually something that was just opened 40, 50 years later anyway.
Right.
So technically, yes, it's that old, but like...
It was sealed and protected.
I mean, it wasn't in any sort of circulation or, you know.
Yeah.
If you're able to find a card that has been open for that long and still tinned...
That's a miracle.
Yeah, like, wow. That's a discovery.
Right.
You know.
That's impressive.
Some unopened shit. That's cool.
It's still cool. It's still a great condition of that year, but it's like, meh. It should be.
Yeah.
Or ish.
Yeah.
And back then, they didn't give a
maybe
fuck.
Maybe like 10 centering or any of that.
Right. They didn't give a fuck about centering back then. Yeah. They just chopped them. Get them out. centering was miserable.
And actually, even way back then, that's why some of the shit that was way off center was slight, did have slight a premium, because it was rarer.
Right, because it was a little different.
Had the next guy on it, or...
Yeah. Error cards back then were a big thing.
Yeah, even printing errors that were just a simple mistake at the factory that got fixed later on.
Yeah.
So somebody caught it.
And now nobody gives a fuck about error cards.
Yeah. Well, they don't even correct actual, like, true errors anymore, ever.
No.
That's, like, not even a thing. It hasn't been for, I don't even know how long.
It's been a while.
Because there's plenty of errors. You'll find errors on cards, but it's just the card now.
Right. No, that's just what it is. It
doesn't matter.
Right.
Jokic being 5'10 or whatever.
Right. On his rookie, a couple that's of right. Rookies, yep. You know? Back in the 80s and 90s, that would have been a huge card.
Well, especially if they made it correct. They would have made it.
They would have, yeah.
Yeah.
They had plenty.
And then whichever one was rarer would have been more sought after. And
they ran those fucking printing presses so long, they had plenty of time to fucking fix that error. Like, we'll print them from here on out good.
Yeah. I mean, they would fix the tiniest little errors. It'd be like somebody's birthday was wrong or fucking. Mm-hmm.
Little tiny things. Fuck face.
I mean, that was a pretty big one, but
the old fuck face card.
Old fuck face, dude. That dude's fucking still famous just because of that.
Yeah,
he signs like shows and shit. Mm-hmm. Like,
he doesn't want to sign. He doesn't want to sign that card though.
Oh, really?
Uh huh. There. Well, this is just a story I was told. This guy at the Dallas show, he was like, he was. I can't remember where he said he was, but he was at a show signing, and he was like, he wanted him to sign. He wanted him to sign in on that card and inscribe fuckface. And he's like, no, yeah. Not doing that. And he's like, he got fucking annoyed too.
Yeah.
I was like, that kind of, after 30 years of that shit, it would get annoying.
That's the only reason you're famous, dog.
Lean into it, dog.
Yeah, nobody cares otherwise. Just bro. If fucking it wasn't for that card, you wouldn't be here.
Right.
But so, asking him to actually sign fuckface, whatever.
That's a little much.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, it's almost like writing, like, I'm a fuckface.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I get it. I wouldn't want his autograph. I don't care about
it. I wouldn't either.
The card is cool.
The card's cool enough just with what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like that Wemby card. Did you see that Wemby one of one that got pulled out of Topps Dynasty? How they put that his autos in there with the jersey, whatever. He, like, fucking...
Oh, he scribbled on
it. He, like, gave himself a mustache and, like, put a tattoo on his face.
I thought that ruined it, bro. My personal opinion,
I thought so too. Yeah. I didn't really care for it either.
It looked like you don't care.
Right.
Like he's clowning.
You're fucking
it.
Off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
whatever.
To each their own.
He's French. Oh. Oh.
He got his fucking ass stomped last night though, I'll tell you that.
Oh
much.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Fucking good old Jokic gave him a little fucking
so serious.
Gave him a little something.
I know quite a people were at that game. Quite a few people who were at that game.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Fucking Simonet was there and Escobar.
Yeah, Unk was there.
Uncle Drew!
Yeah, I know a few people that were there, but that would have been a good game to go to.
Yeah, it would have. That night, the fucking Cleveland Browns Bronco game I went to, when my knee fucking shit out on me, we were going to try to go to, they were playing, Wemby was playing the Nuggets that night in Denver. And so we were going to get double header, we're going to get tickets, do the double header. And my knee said, fuck you, bitch.
That was the plan?
Uh-huh.
Oh, shit.
Well, it wasn't the plan until, like, I didn't know they were there until we arrived. So we got there, and on the little marquee, it said Nuggets Spurs. And we're like, oh, fuck, Wemby's in town. And we were, like, looking at tickets, and I was like, well, let's see how this goes first, because he had a hurt knee too.
Oh, shit.
So we were walking up, and we were fucking sad state of affairs, the two of us. We looked like the fucking, what do you call it, the Make-A-Wish kids. And I'm not making fun of disabled kids. I'm not doing it yet.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, I am. It's the last pod.
Fuck, and your knee hasn't been the same since.
Dude. No.
I mean, was it hurting at all before that?
Yeah. It had been about 2 weeks, and it was fucking pretty shitty. And that morning, I was fine. I went, grabbed some food, went to McDonald's. It was fine. And we drove up there. And as soon as I got out of the vehicle, started walking, it was just like, got worse and worse and worse. Halfway through the game, I was like, I might die. I don't know how I'm going to get out of here.
Put me out of my misery.
I'm like,
leave me here. Carry on.
Those fucking stairs, bro. I was sitting there looking at the stairs. I was like, fuck. I'm gonna have to go down those bitches. You'll
never make it with me. Just go.
I went down there to go get something to eat. I was like, I'm gonna grab something to eat. Come back before the game starts. Dude, it was miserable. It took me forever to go like 30, 40 feet. It sucked. But that was the plan. We were going to get Wemby tickets and ended up not being able to do it because my knee crapped out pretty bad.
Yeah. He'll be back.
Yeah. It'd
have been cool to see him.
Yeah. It'd been cool to see him in his rookie year.
Yeah.
That'd have been dope. But
yeah, especially because he's playing well. So
yeah, he's been doing. You had 9 blocks last night. He almost had a quadruple double.
Yeah.
I was like, what? He blocked Joker a few times too.
Oh, yeah.
He got up in his shit.
But, sure did.
Yeah. But Joker dropped 42 on him. 42.
I mean, there's that.
That did happen. That did happen.
Oh. Why so serious?
MVP, bro. He's going to get his third.
Sure seems that way.
It's looking that way.
Fuck, dude. It should be 4 in a row. How crazy would that be, dude?
Nobody's ever done that, I don't think.
I don't.
I think 3 in a row is the most.
I don't see who could have, bro. Like, maybe
I'm Jordan, fucking old-timer. Jordan.
Fucking maybe. No, Jordan didn't do it, did he?
He didn't do it, but he probably should have.
Yeah.
He just, you know, they just stop voting for you after you get a few in a row. They're just like, all right, somebody else's turn now.
Yeah.
But he had a stretch of like 6-7 years where he was the best player. He was just the best player.
Yeah.
But no, Bird, I think Bird had 3 in a row. And I want to say Wilt Chamberlain had 3 in a row.
Yeah. I'm saying maybe somebody from way back in the day, but
Bill Russell maybe or like something like that. Yeah. Bill like fucking Pistol Pete.
Yeah.
But no, that's nuts. He got jacked for that shit too.
Okay.
Joel Embiid fucking had everybody coming out claiming racism. It's racist. Fuck you, Perkins.
Yeah, dude, for real.
Fucking bitch ass motherfucker. I would never say that to his face, though, because he's probably 7 foot tall.
Yeah.
Probably 400 pounder.
Fucking hammer fist.
Fucking pick me up and snap me like a toothpick between his fingers.
Might eat you. I don't know.
I know. I would be pretty tasty.
But he's a dumb fuck.
He's a fucking moron. He's the worst. He's the worst.
Some of those television and any fucking personality, like, that's TV or internet or any of that, bro. Like, it's like I said a while back, dude. As soon as they start fucking developing their personality or whatever, then they have to stick to it.
Right. Yeah.
He said something one time that fucking got him a bunch of fucking attention, and so he figured he had to keep being like that.
It's his character now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whether it's good or bad, it gets people talking.
Yeah.
And so he keeps doing it.
It gets viral videos and fucking, Yeah, you're right. You're right.
He has some. What do they call it? Not a publicist, like motherfucker tells you what to do and shit.
Like a manager.
Yeah, like.
All right, Perk, how's it going today? Need 2 perks for Perk? We'll get you all perked up, give you Perk 20.
Make sure you mention this, and that, because they really liked it last time.
That racism card really, really worked out.
And they hated when you talked about Joker, so keep that.
Keep talking about Joker. Keep bringing up the race thing because it's that plays, baby.
Yeah, don't say it exactly. Just insinuate and imply as hard as you can.
Don't actually say the racial slur, but just imply it.
Yeah,
but good old Joker. Hope he wins it, man. That'd be dope. More importantly, I hope they win the chip.
I mean, yeah.
But a MVP chip year would be pretty sick.
Yeah, they win another one. I don't give a fuck, but.
Yeah. If they win another one, it's hard not to put Joker in the top, like, centers of all time conversation.
Right? I mean, it's hard to not put him right at the edge already, dude.
Already.
And that's just because he still isn't done.
He's still young. Has a lot of time left. Hopefully, hopefully.
Sure seems like what. He's dense, bro.
Right?
He dense. He not fat. He big boned.
He big boned it. He could ball, man. He threw a pass the other night to KCP. I was like, fuck. He's like, had him here. And it was like the pick and roll, like the fake pick and roll. He came up to set the pick, faked it, and cut. And Joker was standing like this and just saw the cut. and just fucking behind the back, no look, fucking nasty pass, dude. It's like, fuck, Joker, how did you do it?
Dime,
dime, right on the money, bounce pass and everything. It was beautiful.
He was at Mike's signing the other day, KCP.
Oh, was he? That'd have been cool. Yeah. I like KCP.
I think he was there the day of the Denver show, actually, Saturday. Must have been.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He has a lot of nice local Denver athletes at his at his shop.
Yeah.
Mike Stadium Sports Card Shop there in Aurora, Colorado.
He's got the plug from the fucking court, probably.
Yeah, yeah, he's been doing security for the Nuggets for a long time.
Yeah.
At that last all-card, too, he was wearing that Alex English warm-up jacket. That shit was fucking sick.
Yeah. That was game used, he said, too.
Yeah, it was. It belonged to Alex English at one time.
Yeah.
It was pretty cool.
Pretty cute.
It was the old Nuggets. It was the old Cityscape. Mm-hmm. It was dope.
Show off. I'd be flossing that shit, too.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. I would be, too. I would be too.
I don't know. Might be in a frame on my wall. I don't know.
I don't know.
I saw if it fit me.
I saw a kid at the Denver show. I can't remember. I don't think it was. It wasn't this last one. It was a few shows ago. But he was wearing a fucking Mike Trout jersey that was autoed, and I was like, "Oh, he's wearing that shit. Yeah,
is that a real autograph, motherfucker?"
Oh, I was like, "God damn it!" And if it were a real one, it was. Oh my god, it made me so nervous. I don't even trust a kid with a regular T-shirt. I'm going to get fucking ice cream and fucking
boogers
and handprints and shit all over it.
Oh, man. I mean, I've seen people wear them to the ball games, but it's because they get them signed by the players.
Or something. Yeah. I was like, ooh, made my heart jump a little bit. Like, oh, fuck. Yeah. I've never been big into the autographed jerseys, though. I like them.
Yeah.
I like them, but I just don't. I've never really bought them.
Yeah. I mean, I've got the Atwater one, and I kind of wanted an Elway one at one point. I was actually at a Super Bowl party where, I was pissed off. It was like it was somewhere in Springs at some hotel in Springs. I was the chick I was staying with didn't want to go watch it anywhere here, so I was like, fuck it, let's go to Springs, we got a room, and we ended up just watching it in some fucking hotel bar.
Yeah,
it was kind of lame, but it was whatever. But in this bar, they were having a party, and like almost nobody showed up, and they had all these drawings and shit. And one of the prizes was like an Elway jersey, and that's all I fucking wanted, bro. And I fucking, dude, half of those fucking tickets in there had to be mine. Everybody got one just for showing up.
Yeah.
And then I don't even know. I bought like fucking, I don't know, a bunch more, dude. Fucking, there wasn't hardly anybody in the room. Nobody gave a fuck. Nobody even wanted it, bro. And the guy that won it didn't even give a fuck either.
Nah, that sucks.
Yeah, I was pretty fucking sad.
That sucks.
But it was cool. It was all framed. It had like, it was big, too. It had like other pictures and shit with it. And like, had the framed jersey, autographed jersey.
Damn.
It was dope.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's just more shit to fucking dust on your walls, bro.
Yeah.
That's the way I feel about a lot of memorabilia, really.
Yeah.
Cards, you get sick of me, throw them in a box, throw them in your case.
Look at them later.
Yeah. You want to throw a couple on a little shelf somewhere with a little display.
Yeah.
That's cool, but.
Yeah.
They don't take up much space. Especially if it's in a slab or something, in a plastic fucking cover. Psh.
Yeah.
Change out the cover every once in a while, fucking the sleeve or whatever.
Or you can put it in a slab mag, and you can get those exclusively from us at the shop.
There you go.
A little pump and dump. Gotta pump it.
You can get one to match your parallel.
Yeah. Match your parallel, match your slab, team match, whatever. Yeah.
Favorite color.
That's right. I like pink, dog. I like pink. Yeah, dude. Fucking. I was at work today thinking about this pod tonight, and I was thinking about like, just like when we started this in 2021, like August, I want to say, mid-August of 2021, which was still like on the trailing end of the pandy.
Yeah. Yeah.
And fucking.
Yeah, I think technically our first few pods were supposed to be wearing masks and shit.
I'm sure we should have.
Maybe the ones that never made it to the fucking airwaves.
Right. Yeah, we did a couple practice runs. And yeah, dude, fucking, I was thinking about where the hobby is now compared to then. And it's wild, dude. It went a long way from then.
Oh yeah. Like, lots of stuff changed.
PSA and Beckett were like pretty much shut down. HGA was just getting going. And like some of our first podcasts, we were talking about HGA shit, and like it was pretty wild. I was like, man.
Yeah.
I wanna say that's kind of what started us talking about cards. As I got into cause they used to have like a drawing almost, like you wait on HGA's website and then like raffle off of your spot. And I got in 2 times in a row,
mm-hmm.
and I posted some cards on IG, and you're like, and I was like, oh, I got in, I'm going to get these graded from this new company. And I was all excited. And you're like, dude, you fuck with cards. And I was like, yeah. It's like started fucking bullshitting about cards and shit. And it kind of just went from there.
Yeah, fucking good old HGA. We actually kind of liked them, remember?
Oh, I did.
You remember?
I do.
You remember?
I remember I bought a slab of theirs on Facebook, and I was like, yeah. Fuck yeah, this is cool.
Yeah, that's funny. I don't know. Are they still taking submissions?
Yeah.
Yeah.
As far as I know.
Yeah, and there's been another dozen companies that have started since then.
Yeah, yeah. Arena Club and fucking Tag. And
Tag and
FCG.
FCG and Rare Element Edition.
Rare Edition. Cool it now.
That's crazy.
Yeah, there's quite a few. Quite a few, and just so much shit, dude, has happened since then. Like, fucking Fanatics bought Tops, and fucking Snipered all the licensing, and fucking PSA has gone, like, through. I mean, Nat Turner was new to PSA when we first started doing this. And Fanatics had fucking Josh Luber, and, like, there was all kinds of shit. I was kind of looking back and thinking about what, like, all the shit we talked about and all the stuff that we've, like, hit up on the pod. It was crazy.
And so many things that have become like mainstream since then too, that were even like the Zion cases and shit.
You yeah.
know? Like fucking Zion became like the one, you know, there was all these different little ones and,
uh-huh.
but like, it was like Zion became like you're not, it was like the Nike.
Right.
You know,
it's the one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. Fucking shit like that. Star stock has come and gone completely.
Several things like that.
Yeah.
There was.
Remember the fucking, what was the one that you used to like scan your cards and they'd grade them for you?
That's the one I was trying to think of. Card scan. No, what the fuck was it called?
I can't remember, but they had one.
Card score.
Card score. They had one at Iron Lion.
I think the printer's still sitting there, the scanner thing. I don't know. Last time I was in there, I'm pretty sure it was still sitting there, dude.
Really?
I think they just had other crap on it. Like, using it like a shelf now. Well, homie just left his fucking printer in there.
Right? Just fuck it. Just leave it there, man. We owe money on those things anyway.
Yeah, right. The fucking repo man might show up eventually to get that motherfucker.
Don't be surprised if the repo man shows up.
That's crazy, because I bet you they did.
I bet you they did. We still owe 20 grand on each one of those machines, bro. It's okay.
That shit was fucking funny, bro. Man. Yeah, I mean, there's been a lot come and go, and that's the crazy thing is what the, you know, the boom brought all these fucking crazy ideas and all this fucking shit and all this competition and all this stuff, and now years later some of that stuff is lingering, but the better, or maybe not even the better, but only a few are left behind, whether it's just what the hobby chose, like we always say, the hobby says, or
yeah.
or the better companies or whatever, you know, like it's all getting a little thinned out now, and it's starting to kind of, okay, well, this is where we're going to go. Or
it's leveling yeah. off. Yeah, it's true. It's true. Like a lot of the, like fractional shit, that shit came and went. Mm-hmm. I can't remember the names of those. Or one was called,
I can't even remember
the names.
Attention to it, but
yeah,
yeah, me neither right now.
All right, there was some all the fractional shit, all the NFT shit is NFTs, pretty much. Yeah. There's, I think Panini still puts out they NFTs, do. But like, mm-hmm. I don't know how popular they are.
Yeah, I was talking to a dude a while. It's been a while, but a few. I think it was in Springs actually. And there's like some NFTs you could buy like through the UFC site that do cool shit. You know, like get you access to fucking events and some shit like that. You know, fucking. And you were able to pull them through packs somehow, but it wasn't Panini. But yeah. It was on some UFC website, and it sounded cool and interesting. And I was like, well, that's, you know, that's the way that it was always explained that NFTs might be successful, you know,
or yeah.
do something. But yeah. I never hear too many other people talk about them. Honestly, I've never heard really anybody else talking about them but this dude.
So right.
He has all this money in him, and he does all this cool shit with them and shit. But that was for whoever wanted it. But yeah, dude, fucking
Beckett is kind of fallen from grace, and yeah. fucking PSA is solidified, and mm-hmm. PSA fucking, well, collectors bought fucking SGC.
Mm-hmm.
It's wild.
Yeah, and even that, there's still so many things that, man, I'm so curious to see how they play out, you know.
Like, yeah, for sure.
Like things like that, or just Fanatics. You know, we still haven't really tasted. We've gotten a little taste, but we don't know exactly what's going to happen once they have all that licensing and
yeah.
what they're going to do.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, for sure. It's still kind of up in the air.
They just got the UFC, and, you know, my box sucked pretty much. But
yeah,
the design was cool. I liked the fact that they changed the design. Like I've always complained, or not always, but like I've said, mentioned, it sucks how they just use the same design across all the fucking sports and shit.
Yeah.
But it looks like that is going to be a UFC design. They put like almost little octagons kind of in the corner.
Oh, really?
Yeah, there's like a... I didn't bring any out, I guess. But, you know, each corner has like a little shape. It looks like a piece of the octagon kind of in the corner. But it ends up looking like a prism card kind of.
Oh, gotcha.
Kind of looks like a prism design with like a piece of the... It's not an octagon, but it's like that shape in the corner.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And
yeah.
I guess between all four corners, it pretty much makes an octagon, basically, yeah. But it kind of looks like a Panini design, honestly.
Yeah.
So I don't know if they're weaning people off Panini.
We'll give you a little bit of Panini.
Yeah.
Little touch. I don't know.
It's cool. There's no good rookies in it because there's just no good rookies this year. But,
right.
You know,
right.
Company can't help that.
It's not really their fault.
But I've seen a lot of people, a lot of the UFC guys claiming they miss Panini, you know.
Really?
Which is weird, but I think I may have mentioned it a pot or two back where a lot of the UFC collectors, they're newer guys.
Yeah.
And
yeah, that's what they know.
So, the Panini shit is like tops to a lot of guys like us, you know?
Yeah.
You know, like fucking, that's what you started on. So, you have that weird, whether it was better or not, it's like you feel like it was because
you still just have that nostalgia.
Mom's fucking green chili's better, bro.
Right.
You know? Like,
right.
I don't know. Grew up on it or. Yeah, the nostalgia and the...
Yeah, so, it's true.
I don't know. It kind of tripped me out. I had no idea that so many of these UFC guys were going to be... Almost... It's at least 50-50.
Really? Wow.
Crazy, huh?
That's nuts.
Mm-hmm.
What did you just say? Yeah. I hate orphans. Say it again to my face. I hate them.
They're like, I hate tops.
Yep. Bring back Panini.
It's like, yeah, but don't you know?
Panini sucks. Fuck, dude. They had so many redemptions. And that's another thing that fucking happened in UFC card shit. Just to babble on and carry on about who knows what. The Bo Nickel fucking redemptions finally all came through.
Oh, I've really?
About that several times. He wasn't going to sign. He finally did sign, supposedly, but then they never released him, and they were still releasing all this new product with his autographs in it, but nobody still ever got the redemptions from all the old shit. Boom. Everybody got all the redemptions all at once.
No shit.
What does that do to the fucking market?
It just fucking floods the fuck out of it.
Pretty much. I mean, it was like four different fucking at least three, you know, different products.
Every asshole on earth. Once. Yeah.
Whereas usually, eBay. The new one comes out, you fucking can sell them for a few months till the new product comes out, and then now that's the new hotness. And
right.
Sell that for a few months, and then
right.
Now all of a sudden there's fucking 1,200 fucking base fucking... Bo Nickel autos out there, and everybody thinks they're going to be worth $200 like they would have been
in like release. They should have been, yeah.
I mean, they would have gone down by now, probably, you know.
Yeah, Yeah, but you could have had a little bit of a heyday with them.
And now you can get a numbered one for what they should be, probably. But, you know, when things come out the gate, usually you can get fucking double.
Get a little premium there.
Yeah. If you're, you know, some of the first ones to market.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
So, yeah, I don't know. That kind of sucks. I'm glad everybody finally got their cards, but at the same time, it kind of sucks because now everybody got them all at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's not even per product. It's like, oh, we pull a few every fucking day throughout the product. It's like,
wa-boom.
They fucking probably shipped out 1,000 cards that day.
Yeah.
You know, or more. I don't know.
Just fucking pumping them out. Yeah. That's crazy. That's so fucking shitty.
Right. Kind of sucks.
Yeah.
But again, I said, like, you know, I'm not talking shit about these UFC guys, but a lot of them are new, bro. And they don't get it. And they don't understand. Well, why is that going to fuck up the market? It should still be worth all this money.
It's worth what it's worth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Supply and demand and all these other factors that matter, that it takes a minute to learn and figure out.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. It's true. It's true. Fuck, dude. That's crazy that they would release them like that.
Yeah.
You'd think they would. I mean, like, you would think that they would know better and have more sense, but they.
Well, they should have had a contract lined up with him before they ever fucking announced or put his product in the fucking.
Right.
Or his autograph in the product.
Right. They fucked that up pretty bad.
Yeah, and that's what they've been doing this whole fucking time, I think, with everybody.
Yeah.
You know? Then they finally get these guys to fucking sign and.
Yeah, that's wild. That's wild. Even that, dude, like UFC cards, like they weren't. Tops didn't have the licensing, so they weren't putting out UFC cards. And fucking Panini got in. They put out that Prism. I think it was the first year was what, 2020 Prism? 2020 Prism.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, UFC has gone to Panini and then fucking out. Now they're back to Topps again in the time period that we've been doing the pod.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, because they were still selling the 2020 product at that point. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was 2020, but it was in 2021. They were selling a lot of it.
Right.
Obviously, that's the way it, yeah.
Everything was behind schedule,
everything
too.
Always is, kind of, but yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I remember wanting to buy a couple of boxes of 2020 Prism UFC just to put away. Because it was first year Prism. I was like, it's going to be worth something someday.
Mm-hmm.
And it still might. It still might.
Yeah, the hobby boxes will probably, but the retail shit went way. I mean, fuck, dude. Even fucking Blasters, that shit, were going for $70-$80.
Mm-hmm.
Now you could probably get them back for $20-$30.
So yeah.
Pretty much original price. No.
Yeah, that happened since we started the pod. The fucking retail boom was going crazy. I remember I bought a blaster of Select Football, 2020 Select Football, for $100.
Damn.
At John's, or not John's, Mike's.
At a shop?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
$100.
Yeah, even the shops were flipping fucking retail.
Mm-hmm. People were getting shot in the fucking parking lots and shit.
Yeah.
I remember buying a optic blaster of football.
And over some shit you can barely get fucking autographs out
of. Oh, yeah. I bought a optic blaster for, I think it was $110.
Damn. Yeah, and that's why I think Chrome is so much superior to fucking Prism, because Chrome, you can still get all the fucking hits, bro.
Uh-huh.
Whether the odds are a little different or not, you can still hit the dopest card out of a Walmart pack, not just as easily, but you can still hit it.
Yes.
Just like you can in a fucking hobby.
Right.
You know, the odds might be different. It might be harder to hit, whatever, but
it's still possible. Yeah.
In products like Prism and shit, it's not even possible to get a fucking.
You can't even get a numbered card.
Yeah. Yeah. Most of the time, you can't get an autograph or a numbered card or anything, dude.
Yeah.
There's no way you're going to. If you open it current year with the current star, like Stroud or whoever, and the fucking parallels are going for $800, non-numbered parallel for some stupid reason, going for $500.
Right.
Hurry the fuck up, open it, buy it, fucking
flip it,
maybe, and sell it or something.
Yeah.
That's it.
Silvers. Hopefully you can get
a silver.
Prism silver. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And even those are hard to get hit in those boxes. They're hard to hit. I mean, you'll get one or two rookies, but it's always fucking a lineman or some bullshit. But yeah, that's the whole retail.
Unless your name is Miguel Southworth.
No
shh.
Yeah, that dude. He bought a fucking. We had two prison boxes left from after the Pueblo show, and he bought those two, and he had a fucking Stroud fucking, what do you call it, laser, $125 card at right out of that box. I was like, son of a bitch. I never seen anything like it. He's like got the Midas touch, bro.
Lucky dude. But he deserves it. He's a good kid.
Yeah, he's cool. He's cool. For sure. Miguel Southworth. yeah, dude. Yeah.
Southie's not as lucky. He just spends a lot.
He goes hard.
Yeah.
At night he was on the pod. He brought over like 30 blasters maybe. He was going hard for that prism.
Yeah, them tomato boys spend a lot too, but they're pretty lucky too.
They hit, yeah, he hit that crazy Tatum auto, that rookie auto.
I've seen some guys rip just as much as any of them and not hit a goddamn thing.
Yeah, <That's all>. Yeah, it's true.
Yeah,
it is true. I'm the worst. I hit nothing. I hit nothing.
Bro, I've been striking out. I mean, I haven't ripped much, but like anything that I have in the last fat year.
It's been tough.
Pretty brutal. Pretty brutal.
That prism football box, though, was the worst, I think, I've ever seen.
Man, that was horrible. That UFC box was pretty bad. That prism chrome, I mean, that Topps chrome box.
Was it really?
One of my best cards was a rookie gold out of 50, and it was a guy that lost his, it's a rookie card of a guy that lost his last five fights. Oh, fuck.
God damn it. Like, fuck, dude. Yeah. It's gold. It's gold, son. Wah, wah.
Yeah, pretty bad.
Yeah.
Fun, but.
It's know. Always fun.
Yeah, you can always go gambling, I guess, at fucking Cripple Creek or Blackhawk and lose it 10 times faster.
Yeah. Get a $400 beer.
And then you gotta sit there all sad, dude. You don't. Yeah, if you're not playing, they don't give you shit.
You're sitting there nursing it.
That's when you go
play, taking little sips.
Go play video poker and you bet one quarter at a time and just like. And you're like doing a countdown. You're trying to count to 100 every time you push a button. You're like, one, two. Like at least 2 minutes go by every time you
ding,
and that was just to raise the bet. You didn't even do anything, you're just kind of acting like you're playing,
bloop,
clicking some shit back and forth.
Oh, yeah, dude. My friend Anthony used to run around the casino and look for the waitress, and then as soon as he'd see her, he'd sit down at a machine, act like he's playing, and he's like, miss, can I get a drink? And she's like, yes, you fuck.
And then cash out right away.
Yeah. Get his beer, cash out. Chasing waitresses.
Spending $200 to get four free beers, just chasing them around like that. You're going to win.
Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah, it's still fun.
It's always a good time.
Hell yeah.
Always a good time. Yeah, dude, fucking, I don't know, man. Been a good run, brother.
Yeah, dude. Fucking so much fun. Met so many cool people, bro.
So many cool people.
Some great friends, bro. Some people that have become some of my best friends because of this shit, bro. So,
yeah.
Shit sucks. But, yeah. I'll still see everybody at the shows and shit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We'll still be a mainstay in the hobby here in Colorado for
fucking
sure.
A. Yeah, and that's the thing, too, is I feel like we fucking... I feel like we... contributed to that pretty good, you know.
I think
like,
so.
Maybe not just the pod, but everything, you know, fucking with the show and just showing up at these other shows and setting up and trade nights.
Yeah, supporting.
I feel like we contributed pretty good to helping this shit grow over the last couple of years.
Yeah, here, for know? Sure, absolutely.
So I'm proud of that.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
I mean, maybe it wasn't what we had originally set out to do or hoped for, or, you know. The way we talk isn't funny to everybody for
right.
some weird fucking reason. I don't
know. Bunch of fucking lame ass motherfuckers.
But the people that fucking love it, dude, fucking, they think it's hilarious. And,
yeah.
You know, so that's cool.
Yeah. For sure.
You know, it ain't for everybody, and that is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
It is what it is.
Met some cool people and even some folks that we've yet to shake hands with, like Rob Cards. We have yet to sit down and, like, actually talk with Rob.
Some guys that I've done trades with, you know, because of the pod. And
yeah.
You know, reached out, sent them shirts and things. And
yeah. Like Uncle Drew?
Yeah.
I couldn't imagine my life without Uncle Drew.
Yeah, I bullshit with him a lot often, bro. And it's really funny how coincidental him and I have so many things in common, bro, about our past and, like, some of the people we grew up with and some of the things that we did when we were young. And even we have been to some of the same concerts, bro.
Uh-huh.
Not even known, you know. But wait, decades before we knew each other.
Yeah.
You know, we were, like, literally in the same fucking building and shit.
You know? Yeah. Yeah.
Same interests and doing the same shit, like, our whole fucking lives. And just,
it's like, we were destined,
ran into each other,
destined to be friends, so, man. Like, yeah. we should be friends.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, pretty cute.
Yeah, definitely cool.
But
definitely cool.
Yeah, who knows what happens in the future, dude. Fucking
yeah, you know, things could change. Fucking fire this bad boy back up.
Yeah,
it would not break my heart to fire this pod back up, for sure.
Word.
But I thought about, like, trying to go on and do it differently or do it with other people, and then I'm like, it just wouldn't hit the same, dude. I would feel fucking weird. I'd feel like I was cheating on you, dog.
That fucking Coke from fucking McDonald's just tastes different, dog.
It just tastes different.
Yeah. It's, you know, I think there's still a place for it. And I think it's, you know, like you've said before, there's a, it's a hole in the hobby, you know, kind of that, for this kind of shit that people are afraid to embrace or afraid, not to embrace, but to share or to let other people know. Even like you said about your homie just talking about cars, he was almost embarrassed, you know, to talk about cars.
Yeah,
not everybody thinks this shit's funny, bro. And for somebody to say, hey, go listen to this shit, and then some of the shit we say, they might be like, oh damn, they might think differently of the person they introduced us to. About, you know? Bro, they said fucking dick a lot.
Talk shit, bro.
They're talking about titties and fucking,
he said this fucking
smoking weed the whole time. Wow,
did he just say somebody's growing a dick out of their arm?
So, I mean, I get it. It's not for everybody.
It's not. Yeah, it's not. But it's all good.
It's Def Comedy Jam, bro.
That's right. And we were, the thing that was I thought was the coolest, bro, about the pod is we kept it authentic.
Mm.
You are you, who you are on this pod, and so am I. You know,
and that's why we can't keep going, because we can't fucking change it, because it wouldn't be the same.
It wouldn't be the same. It wouldn't be right.
It would not be the same.
Yeah, so. For sure. For sure. But, yeah, dude. We got to do another shot. Here's to you, homie, the pod.
Fucking A.
Whew.
Which one was that? Doers?
Doers.
Yeah. Nobody else was doing anything quite like it, bro. And I think the people that fucking dug it really appreciated it.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. And fucking, I know from speaking for me, and I'm probably pretty sure for you, anybody that listened or gave us some time and fucking hit us up and talked to us and sent us messages or whatever, dude, fucking appreciate you guys more than I could ever fucking say.
Yep.
All the friends we've made that come to bullshit at the shows and fucking, it's cool, man. It's been cool and it's been a lot of fun. And,
Yeah, socials will still be there. Send a message.
Yeah.
Even if you never did before, you know.
Yeah.
You want to say fucking laters, whatever.
Later, boys. Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Still fucking always going to be at most of these fucking shows.
Yep. Yep.
Come say what's up.
And we'll still be listening to some Wu-Tang.
Come smoke a fucking bowl.
Yeah.
Or your vape pen if you're from California. No, just kidding. They do that shit here, too.
They do it here, too, like a motherfucker. I actually have one myself.
Oh, yeah, that's right. My bad, dog. Shit.
It's okay.
I got one, too.
Yeah, I figured.
But
goddamn right.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of a necessity nowadays.
It kind of is, if you want to smoke on the sneaks, kind of. Yeah,
on the sneaky sneak.
On the little sneaky sneak.
Yeah, or you could just fire up a fat fucking bowl.
Yeah, dude, so That's all I got for the pod. Anything else you want to hit up before we get up out of here, dude?
No, just make sure you guys keep supporting all this fucking Colorado shit best you can. Fucking, if you listen to the pod and you're not from here, come check out one of these fucking Big Denver shows or the Spring shows or even our little fucking show down here has been getting fucking so cool and popular.
Yeah.
Fucking 50 tables this last time, but it's probably, I don't know, man. If you could find a cooler 50 table fucking show, then I would like to go to that show.
Yeah, invite me. Yeah, it's a cool show. It's turned into a cool show. And we're going to keep doing the show, you know, so definitely keep that going for sure.
Yep. So come visit. Come say what's up. Come chill in Colorado. It's the dopest fucking, I can't say it's the dopest card scene, but it's fucking pretty legit. But it's the dopest scene.
Yeah.
Say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
I mean, there might be bigger shows with better cards, you know, just because they're bigger cities and
more
fucking exclusive to the hobby and all these famous people go there or whatever.
Right.
But you're not going to find a cooler spot.
Yeah. With cooler people, cooler vendors.
Yeah.
Like Colorado vendors that set up at all these shows are fucking awesome.
You're not going to find a better community.
Definitely.
There's no fucking way.
Definitely will not. You might have some that are about as good or as good, but not better.
Yeah.
Not better.
Not saying ours is better than anywhere else, but you're not going to find a better one.
Right.
Yeah.
For sure. 100%.
Yeah, we're better than everybody else.
Nah, we're fuck everybody else. We're way better. Yeah, for sure, man. But thank you for fucking
you too, homie.
Doing this shit for almost 3 years, dude.
Yeah, man. Fucking the whole fucking pod was your idea, bro, and we would never even start it if it wasn't for you, so.
Right on, man.
Yeah. And even at first, I was like, I don't know, man. But then once we started doing it, it was so fun. And fucking, it was dope. And we had so much fun. Met so much cool people. Had a blast. Yep. That's it, man.
Yep. Yep. So thank you guys again. And we're going to jump on out of here. And we're going to make you cry a little bit with some exit music. But thank you all for supporting the pod. And you never know. We might be back someday.
You never know. You never know.
But once again, for the last time, guys. Alias. Right, it's like I'm gonna be somebody else. I'm gonna be that. You could be that character from Lord of the Rings or whatever the fuck.
Aragorn, J-Bone Capone.
But once again, guys, appreciate you so much. And for the last time, peace out.
All right.
Later. How do I say goodbye to? The good time that made us laugh, I'll wait them back. I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye.